Hey friends, welcome to Day 9 Current Affairs. The first news is, government to provide ₹5,559 crore funding to North East Gas Grid. The Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs approved a ₹5,559 crore viability gap funding for the proposed North East Gas Grid. A viability gap funding of 60% of the project cost has been approved. The quantum of viability gap funding would be capped at 60% of estimated project cost and would not be linked with upward capital cost variation. This is only the second instance of the government directly funding a gas pipeline. The funding support to the gas grid is a part of the broader goal of the government to raise the share of natural gas in the country's energy mix to 15% by 2030 from the current 6.2%. In 2016, the government provided a capital grant of 40% of the project cost of 2,655 km Jagdishpur to Haldia and Bokaro to Dhamra gas pipeline project, which GAIL is currently executing. GAIL is also laying 750 km line from Barauni to Gahoti as part of JHBDPL project, which is also known as the Pradhan Mantri Urja Ganga project. This is proposed to be connected to the northeast via Indradhanush grid. All other pipelines in the country have been funded by public or private sector companies. Only except this. Second news. Cabinet nod for ordinance enabling FDI in coal mining. This was recently in news in lockdown time, means COVID-19 time, that there are some issues have happened related to the coal mining FDIs. For that, cabinet given nod. The union cabinet has approved an ordinance to amend two laws to ease mining rules enabling FDI in coal mining. In 2018, the government had allowed commercial mining by private entities, but now non-coal companies could not participate in the auction. In August 2019, the government announced 100% FDI under the automatic route in coal mining for open cell, besides creating associated infrastructure such as washeries. The ordinance to amend the Mines and Minerals Development and Regulation Act 1957 and the Coal Mines Act 2015 has been approved at the cabinet meeting chaired by Prime Minister. In a bid to attract investments and boost domestic coal production, the ordinance would open up coal mining in the country to non-local, non-coal companies while removing restrictions on the end use of the fuel. Under the ordinance, allocation of coal lignite blocks for composite prospecting license cum mining lease has been provided. Requirement of previous approval in cases where the allocation of blocks was made by the central government has been dispensed with. The government is aiming at achieving production of 1 billion tons by 2023-2024. Means some HDI restrictions are eased because to develop, means improve the production of the coal which is low in our country. Third, revised norms for data-led probes. The Union Home Ministry has said that before seeking information about a person's email account hosted on servers in foreign countries, investigating agencies will have to establish that it is linked to a crime. Means if at all it is linked to a crime, then only they should seek the information. Most intermediaries and social media platforms such as Facebook, WhatsApp, Google, Yahoo, Twitter and YouTube have their servers outside India. Regrassing is mandatory after mining, rules Supreme Court. A bench led by the Chief Justice of India, Bobde, ordered the government to include regrassing of mined areas as a mandatory condition in every mining lease, environmental clearance and mining plan across the country. Means for every mining lease, there should be a regrassing as mandatory. That was asked by Chief Justice of India to the Indian government. The Supreme Court has ordered that mining leaseholders should be held responsible for regrassing mined areas so that biodiversity gets a second chance in these scarred landscapes. Environmental issues caused by mining include erosion, formation of sinkholes, loss of biodiversity, and contamination of soil, groundwater, and surface water by chemicals from mining processes, and the effects persist for years. An area which is mined results in complete elimination of grass, which in turn denies fodder to the herbivores. The only solution can be regrassing of such mined areas. It is not in the dispute that the regrassing technology is available in the country, Chief Justice Bobde said. Next, 2019 was the 7th warmest year in India since 1901, says IMD. The rise in average temperatures over India in 2019 was the lowest since 2016. According to a report from India Meteorological Department, nevertheless, the year that went by was the 7th warmest since record keeping commenced in 1901. During the year, the annual mean surface air temperature averaged over the country was +0.36 degrees centigrade above average. The average is defined as a mean temperature from 1980 to 2010. According to the World Meteorological Organization, the rise in global mean surface temperature during 2019, January to October, was +1.10 degrees centigrade. Next, Karakal Wildcat. National Board of Wildlife has approved the inclusion of Karakal into the list of critically endangered. You can remember this because it will be important as perspective of the IUCN list. Karakal asking to list the means National Board of Wildlife is asking to include Karakal wildcat as critically endangered species for taking up conservation efforts with financial support under centrally sponsored scheme. Development of wildlife habitat. It is a medium-sized wild cat found in some parts of Gujarat and Rajasthan. EDUON 2020. Recently, Union Educational Minister has inaugurated the 2-day virtual international Aghan conference, EDUCON 2020. Theme: Envisioning Education for Transforming Youth to Restore Global Peace. Last news for today, January 19. Today is Pravasi Bharatiya Divas. 2021 marks the 16th Pravasi Bharatiya Divas. It is celebrated to mark the contribution of overseas Indian community. Theme: Contributing to Atmanirbhar Bharat. This is for today current affairs. We'll meet tomorrow again for our next tomorrow current affairs. Thank you very much. Please subscribe, share, like, comment, and dislike. Thank you once again.